In today's video, I wanted to sit down and chat with you guys about a really important topic, at least it is very important for everyone, and it is digestive health and gut health. Hello guys, I'm Agnes and this is the Bites Fitness YouTube channel, and if you haven't yet, please subscribe to our channel if you like our content. And we also have social media, so let's be friends on Instagram, on Facebook, on Twitter and on Pinterest. Our account name is Bites Fitness and of course you can find all the links in the description below. So let's begin this video, and I have some thoughts that I wrote down here and I want to share with you guys, so let's jump in. First of all, just a quick disclaimer for you guys. I'm not offering any advice or tips on any medical condition, so if you are feeling any symptoms or feeling sick, you should definitely see your doctor and consult a doctor about your condition. These tips are all in general and they are healthy and natural advice and tips for improving your digestion. So why is healthy digestion important? Your body breaks down the food you eat into nutrients in your body, and these nutrients are absorbed in your gut. If you have poor gut health, these nutrients can't absorb properly, which can lead to chronic illnesses, diseases and digestive issues like IBS or other problems. Good digestion is also in connection with mental health, because there is a connection between your brain and your gut. And if you have poor gut health, your mental health will also suffer. You can have mood swings, you can have chronic fatigue or brain fog, for example, these symptoms are very common, and it works the other way around as well. So if you have poor brain health or you have mental problems, you have anxiety or you have a lot of chronic stress in your life, your digestion will suffer as well. So my first tip is to eat a lot of whole foods that are rich in fiber, both soluble and insoluble fibers as well. And fiber in general supports your health and your digestive health in a lot of different ways. Insoluble fiber-rich foods include whole grains and vegetables, and soluble fiber-rich foods are nuts, legumes, and oats. Yeah. So my second tip is a healthier digestion is to drink a lot of water. The fiber pulls the water in the colon and it helps with a smoother and easier digestion. And dehydration, if you don't drink enough water, can lead to constipation and other digestive problems. The water is not just the water you drink from your glass, but all your food contains fluids as well. Oats, for example, grains, your fruits and vegetables, so those are also included in your daily fluid intake. So let's take that into consideration, and with everything, the water, the soups, the teas and everything, you should take in 2 or 3 liters of water or fluids every single day. My third tip is to eat probiotic foods. Probiotic is the same bacteria that is in your gut, so it can strengthen your gut health, it can enhance the nutrient absorption as well, so it is really helpful. And what are probiotic foods? Mostly fermented foods like sauerkraut or fermented dairy products, kefir or yogurt, pickles as well, or fermented soybeans, miso, for example. My fourth tip is prebiotic food, which is not the same as probiotic. Prebiotic food feeds the probiotic in your gut, and these foods include onions and other raw fruits and vegetables like bananas or oats as well. These also support the healthy bacteria in your gut. Let's move on to my next tip, which is herbal teas. They are great natural remedies for digestive health. Peppermint tea is a great one and a big one. It is really popular and it is a very important support for your digestion and your gut health. Fennel can also be very supportive, and chamomile tea, for example. And the other ones can also be ginger and green tea. My sixth tip is a bit of a lifestyle one, but it also includes nutrients and nutrition as well. And it is mindful eating and regular eating on a routine. It is very important to eat somewhat on a pattern every single day. You want to eat about at the same time for breakfast, for lunch, for dinner, and for your snacks as well. And you want to pay attention to your food and to sit down. Don't watch TV, don't read anything. Concentrate on your food, concentrate on chewing it, the taste, and really be mindful of your eating. My seventh tip is to limit or entirely cut off any processed food and sugary food in your diet. For me, this was a big one, because sugar sweeteners, artificial sweeteners, and processed food in general can cause inflammation and reduce the number of the good bacteria in your gut, and this can cause any chronic inflammation, and that can lead to chronic illnesses in the long term in your body. Studies say that artificial sweeteners also destroy the good bacteria in your gut, and so does all this processed food. So you definitely need to take this into consideration when you eat these next. Let's move on to my final couple of tips, which are mostly lifestyle related. And my first one is exercise. Regular exercising can improve bowel movement, and it can reduce constipation and overall improve your digestive health. My last one here is stress management, and chronic stress can be a really huge part in our everyday life these days, and it can cause some really big strain on our digestion. So we need to learn how to manage our stress levels. And there are techniques like meditation, relaxation, or yoga as well, breathing techniques that can really help you. So I suggest you, I'm not an expert. There are a ton of different books and videos on this topic, so I suggest you dig in and find something that works for you. Lastly, I just want to mention that if you experience any symptoms that seem to be not okay or not natural, for example, if you eat certain foods, you might have food intolerance or food sensitivity for certain things like gluten, dairy, or any other types of food. So I really suggest you visit a doctor or take a test and find it out, so you can eliminate those food types and those products, and your digestion will improve significantly. Just one moment. We have a visitor here. Thank you so much for watching this video, guys. If you liked it, please make sure to hit the thumbs up button, and also please leave me a comment below with your feedback or what you think, or if you have any other suggestion or tip. I would love to get your feedback, guys, and your thoughts on this topic. It is very important. Bye, guys. If you like this video, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, and you can find a lot of similar style videos on there. And also you can check out our recommended videos. Maybe you will find something that you are interested in.